Hello everyone, today we discuss about 8th session of Unit 1, Heat Power Engineering. Today, content is the laws of thermodynamics. There are three laws of thermodynamics. First one, zeroth law of thermodynamics. Second one, first law of thermodynamics. Third one, second law of thermodynamics. In a second law of thermodynamics, there are two statements. First one is the Kelvin flux statement. And the second one is the Clausius statement. The first one, zero law of thermodynamics. Zero law of thermodynamics states that when two systems are in a thermal equilibrium with a third system, then the two systems are also in thermal equilibrium with each other. So in figure A, B, C. Consider system A is in thermal equilibrium with system C. Also, system B is in thermal equilibrium with system C. According to zeroth law of thermodynamics, system A and system B are also in thermal equilibrium. So, this zeroth law of thermodynamics is what we have to do. This A and B, system A and B, system C ಜೊತೆ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಈಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಆಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಈ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಎ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಬಿ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಈಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತವೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಡೈನಮಿಕ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಡೈನಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. That is the energy neither be created nor be destroyed. So first law of thermodynamics is that energy is created or destroyed. So energy one param in the inner param is converted. So in this figure there are two states, state 1 and state 2. So heat transfer from state 1 to state 2 and work done from these two states. So E is internal energy, E2 minus E1 is equal to Q minus W. So E2 minus E1 is change in internal energy and is equal to Q is heat added minus work done. So Q is equal to delta E plus W, where Q is the amount of heat added, delta E is change in internal energy, W is work done. Second law of thermodynamics. The second law of thermodynamics can be explained by the following two statements. First one, Kelvin flux statement. Second one, Clausius statement. Kelvin flux statement. Kelvin flux statement states that it is impossible to construct an engine working in a cyclic process converts all the input heat energy into an equivalent amount of work output. ಈ ಕೆಲವು ಟೈಪ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಇಂಜಿನ್ 100% ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು ಹೇಟ್ ಏನು ಇನ್ಪುಟನ್ನು ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅದು ಫುಲ್ output work ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೂಲೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದೆನ್ ದಿ ಇಂಜಿನ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ statement. Clausius statement states that it is impossible to construct an engine working in a cyclic process transfer heat from a body of lower temperature to a body of higher temperature without the assistance of external energy. Clausius statement ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಇರೋಂಥ ಬಾಡಿಯಿಂದ higher temperature iranta madige naavu heat flow agalla idu flow aagbeku andre yavadare external assistance athwa external source irlebeku so in other words heat cannot flow from cold body to hot body without external assistance ಇದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬಾಡಿಯಿಂದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೂ ಎಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲದಲೇ ಹೀಟು ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸಿಂಕ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಹೀಟ್ ಇಂಜಿನ್ The source, the temperature is higher than sink. So the heat is easily flow from source to sink through heat engine. But in heat flow from sink to source. Always sink is lower temperature and source is higher temperature. So source is hot body and sink is cold body. So in this case, the heat flow from sink to source a heat pump. So in this the work is done by the operating the heat pump. So the heat is easily flow from sink to source through heat pump. Next, the multiple choice questions. The law of thermodynamics states that when two state systems are in thermal equilibrium with a third system, then two systems are also in thermal equilibrium with each other, is known as zeroth law of thermodynamics. So, option B is correct. Option A, first law of thermodynamics, option C, second law of thermodynamics, and option D, last statement are wrong statement. So, option B, zeroth law of thermodynamics is the correct answer. Next, energy neither be created nor be destroyed. So, option C is correct answer. A, B, C, sorry, A, B and D are wrong. Next, heat supplied to the system is equal to the sum of change of internal energy and external work done. So, option D is correct. Option A, pressure, option B, temperature, and option C, heat are wrong answers. So, you choose the option D. Next question is, first law of thermodynamics deals with option A, conservation of heat, option B, conservation of momentum, option C, conservation of mass, option D, conservation of energy. So option D, conservation of energy is correct answer. Next, first law of thermodynamics defines option A, heat, option B, work, option C, entropy, option D, internal energy. So option C, entropy is the correct answer. Next, Kelvin Planck's deals with option D, conservation of heat energy, heat into work. So option A, conservation of energy, option B, conservation of heat, option C, conservation mass are wrong answer. So option D is correct. Next, practically no machine is option A 25% efficient, option B 50% efficient, option C 75% efficient, option D 100% efficient. So D is correct. That is 100% efficiency here alone. Next, unit of energy is option A Kelvin, option B centigrade, option C joule, and option D watt. So unit of energy is joule or kilojoules or newton meter. Here only one answer is joule, that is C. So C is correct. Next, standard temperature taken as option A 0 degree Celsius or 273 Kelvin, option B is 50 degree Celsius or 288 Kelvin, option C 100 Kelvin, option D 0 Kelvin. Here option B 15 degree Celsius or 288 Kelvin is correct. Next, heat cannot flow from cold body to hot body without external assistance. So option A is correct. Option B, universe. Option C is surroundings. And option D, boundary are not correct. Thank you.